وثبت على دينه حتى أتاه اليقين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحابته ومن اتبع سنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Today marks the second sad anniversary of the brutal, inhumane murder of the Saudi journalist Jamal Khashoggi in his own country's consulate in Istanbul. And up until today, justice has not been done. Justice has not been done for an ummah that prides itself on being an ummah of justice. This is a sad day that 2 years would go by and the criminals are protected by their own government. This is very sad. This is very, very sad. We are not going to divert from our main subject, which is about the Quran. The Quran itself prides us on being an ummah of amrum bil ma'ruf wa nahi an al munkar. When we see what is wrong, we should speak up. Our silence is betrayal. It betrays our deen, it betrays our commitment to Allah, and it renders us as easy prey for anyone. Anyone can take any part of our ummah, tear it down, completely decimated, and the rest of the ummah living as if there is nothing happening. But the description of our ummah is more detailed even in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We all know the hadith. The example of the Muslim ummah is like that of one body. If any part suffers from aches or pain, the rest of the ummah, the rest of the body, suffers from sleeplessness and fever. This is the ummah. Oh, but this is the ummah that was alive. This is the ummah that was sensitive to each other, considerate to the feeling of each other. One tribe cares for the other, one person cares for the other, and everyone cares for the rest of the ummah. This is the description in the hadith. But when this body is disconnected, the hands are separate from the body, the legs are cut away from the body, then we don't feel what's going on. So life goes on. It is quite unfortunate that this is the situation of our ummah today. But apart from lamenting the reality and regretting where we are, we need to be reminded, and this is my point today, we need to be reminded that when we are sensitive to the Quran, when we are responsive to the Quran, we do what the Quran says. The Quran says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ, in plural, be you all standing up for justice, and be witnesses unto Allah. Be Allah's witnesses. But a witness does not stand up to be silent, and does not talk falsehood, and does not bear false witness. When our ummah was silent in 1948, Palestine was taken. And in the 50s, Pakistan and India separated, and from there, the sub-Indian continent started to fragmentize, to be fragmented, right and left. We need to be a lively ummah, as our book is a book for life and living, as our deen is meant for us to live by the book, not just by matters that we eat, or clothing that we wear, or cars we ride, or careers and jobs that distract us from what matters most, this is not the life for the Muslim. So this is just a reminder as to what the Quran really does when we are a lively ummah. The example is very, very known. A woman in Amuriya, Syria today, her clothing were lifted by a man who was not a Muslim. And she cried. And she said, "Wa Islama." That's all what she said. In the market, she feels ashamed and exposed in public, unnecessarily aggression and abuse. And she calls, "Where is Islam? Where are the Muslims?" And the Muslim caliph, on the same day, sent the army all the way from Iraq to Syria. No airlifting, no C-17 or C-130. They were all on foot, but never hesitated. The Khalifa al-Mu'tasim Billah al-Abbasi, he did not hesitate. He knew that this is a must. It is not a choice. And it is not a favor that he is doing. He didn't ask, "Who is this woman? Or what is her tribe? Or how much money she has?" None of that matters. These were the days when our ummah was united. And that's why every one of our ummah's enemies never want us to unite. So what do? They malign the word Khalifa and the word Khilafa. They make them look like a taboo, and they artificially manufacture a whole group to master this maligning of this word, so that our ummah, including the Islamists, they would say, "No, we don't want to do Khilafa." What is Khilafa? Khilafa is United Muslims. So they have the right to give themselves to set up the United States of America, right? The European Union, in which they admit whom they like and they kick out whom they like. But we do not have the right to establish our own united ummah. So they use the Arabic word and malign it so that no Muslim would want to talk about it, let alone work for it. But like the shaitan, a wise Muslim, whenever the shaitan whispers to them to do something, what do they do? If the Muslim is wise, what do? They do the opposite. This is what our ummah needs to do. There is no power in disunity. And there is no abuse of power when there is unity, because you have to get the consent of every member of your state to do something that would cost them treasure, blood, or limb. So we have to work on getting this Khilafah on its feet and on strengthening our ummah. Allah told us, وَأَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ قُوَّةِ. Prepare for them whatever you can of means of power. When we didn't, this is where we get. And this is what we get. An ummah that is weak, fragmented, exploited, and there is no condolence for somebody who kills himself with his own hands. If we kill ourselves, if we squander our means, if we let our tyrants manage our money and our lives and our resources, this is what we get. An ummah that is begging its own enemies for money, for weapons, for extensions, for loans, for investment, as if Allah left us orphans and they are our guardians. This is the reason, the bottom line reason for our curse. Silence when we can do better. Silence when we can speak. Somebody would say, but we have brutal regimes. They kill you if you speak. Don't you mention Khashoggi? Yeah, but Khashoggi did not die. Because his cause did not die. And people like him do not die. If and only if we carry the just cause that they have died for. They have been killed for us to live. What is the point if we don't live? Did they squander their life? Did they waste their energy? Was it not worth it for us? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us do what is right and stand up for what is right, because less than that, our faith is too poor to carry us forward. You can't give your faith the minimum and ask Allah for the maximum. We all pray for Al-Firdaus Al-A'la, the best place in paradise. But when it comes to paying the price that Allah has already purchased from us, we are reluctant, we are hesitant, we are stingy, we are lazy, we are selfish. We need to change all of this. As Allah says, حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُوا مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ, until they change what is in themselves. These are the things that are in ourselves that inhibit us from moving, from standing, from talking, for achieving what Allah has given for us and for all humanity. Dignity. Dignity. We have now states that are Muslims that are living under occupation, indignified treatment and exploitation for decades. When do we move? When do we wake up? Oh yeah, the media will tell you this sheikh is arousing grievances, and grievances lead to terrorism. I want to tell you this. I'm speaking truth where it matters most. Whether my enemies call it inciting or enticing or anything else, I do not really care what the enemies of the Quran and the enemies of Allah would say about me. What matters for me is, what does Allah say about me? How does Allah hear my words? This is what matters. Am I speaking my opinion, or am I explaining the Quran that we must explain? Or should I abandon and be accepted by those who want to write about me? No, we will not be silenced, because silence is betrayal. We will speak up, we will stand up, and we will do what we have to do of our duty, enjoining what is good and stopping what is evil. Like every other community of faith and conscience, everybody is speaking except us. People who believe in abortion, they are speaking for abortion. People who want to abandon and abolish abortion, they are talking against abortion. Why don't we speak for what we believe in and against what we don't believe in? Oh, because we are weak. Our weakness is exactly because of not speaking and not standing for what we believe in. So let us review our relationship with the Quran and our relationship with our Ummah, so that this body is a living body. Many people only want us to speak for them because they are voiceless. And our enemies are speaking with mega mics, both in Washington and elsewhere. Why do we have to be silenced? Why do we accept to be silenced? Because somebody's gonna make a negative comment about us? That's okay. That's okay. Our power is in our dignity. Our dignity is in our unity. So we need to first start the unity of understanding our duties and doing what we have to do, enjoining the good and forbidding what is bad, pushing back against evil that want to destroy us or any just cause, and stand up not only for our just cause, but for everybody's just cause. We should stand with our African American brothers because they are struggling the struggle of their life. This is the moment. Coming late has no value, has no impact. We should stand for the divine values that makes us and all other faith communities unite against what Allah has prohibited. We need to fix our society. We need to fix our community. This is the primary role that we need to play so that we don't have another Jamal Khashoggi. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless his soul and guide us to do what is right. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اتبع سنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم بفضلك يا أرحم الراحمين. Brothers and sisters, I know many of you may not have expected this topic to pop up in your face all of a sudden, but it is our duty that we keep reminding ourselves and other people of faith and conscience that killing one human being unjustly without good cause is like killing the entire humanity. That's why we must stand. Committing injustice against one person means committing injustice against every other person. This is how we understand our faith. And to be honest, we don't need anybody to explain our faith to us. We know all of this. So this is only a reminder. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us benefit from those reminders. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. اللهم قو ضعفنا ولم شملنا واحمل قضيتنا ودافع عن المظلومين منا. اللهم عليك بالظالمين والطغاة والمعتدين فإنهم لا يعجزونك. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين وأحسن عاقبتنا في الآخرين واحشرنا مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فستذكرون ما أقول لكم وأفوض أمري إلى الله. إن الله بصير بالعباد. وأقم الصلاة.